We are super, super, super excited to be back with another live session. So we are waiting for a few more people to join us. And let me just prep up everything so that we can start with this session. Yeah, so there is a lot of work which I have to do alone today. Why? Because Vanya is not there. She's at her cousin's place. So yeah, it's a Christmas vacations for her going on. So yes, I'm definitely missing her. Because she really helps me out with a lot of things. And I'm so happy to see you all. Hi, Anita. Hi, Nancy. Hi, Nimesha. Hi, Preeti. Hi, Vidu. I hope you all are doing good. And thank you so much for joining us for this live session. Because honestly, I was not at all sure that how many of you will join us. Why? Because it's a vacation time. And yeah, I know, like we all are busy with some other vacation work. So I'm just trying to do a little more setup work so that we can start. So yes, what you see on my table is another project which is there on our YouTube channel. Just in case if you have missed out, you can check that on our YouTube channel. And I am absolutely sure that you all are going to love that. Hi Anshu, hi Anu, hi Neeru, hi Harshada. And yes, I know now I remember your names, your all names. So I'm so excited to see you all here. Yes. Hi Deepika, I am absolutely fine and I'm super happy that I'm back with another live session. This box is a mixed media with decoupage box. The video tutorial is there on our YouTube channel. Yes, I also have a scrapbook to show you, Anita. Yes, you got it right. So that's a beautiful, beautiful scrapbook which I have made. I just finished that yesterday. The video is going to be very soon on my live session. Sorry, on my YouTube channel. So for this, you need to check our YouTube channel. Hi, Yashashvi. Hi, Meena. Am I missing out? Hi, Neha. Hi, Ekta. Hi, Mala. Hi, Shushma. Hi, Deepika. Hi, Preeti. Hi, Surendra. Hi, Archana. Thank you so, so, so much for joining in. And I'm super happy. Now for the last session which we took on our YouTube channel, there was a bit of confusion regarding the giveaway. So first thing, you had to comment on any 5 of our YouTube videos. Also, there was a Facebook post which had the link of that session particular, which is already there on our Facebook page. So still, if you have not done that, you will have to start sharing that post. We have extended the duration for the announcement for 1 week. So what you need to do is you need to share that post. And now for today's live session, as it's a Christmas, we thought of doing 5 giveaways. Yes, you heard us right. We have 5 giveaways today. What you need to do is you need to comment on any 10 or of our YouTube videos that's on our YouTube channel. You need to share this live session as much as you can. And 5 lucky winners are going to get goodies from us. Hi, Kuljeet. Hi, Isha. Hi, Anuja. Thank you so much for the Deepika for loving our work. Now, this is a beautiful mixed media box which is there on our YouTube channel. You can check the tutorial. Then this is a beautiful scrapbook what we are coming up with on our YouTube channel. You can check this also. And now, what next? So what are we going to do? That's a very important question. That is because a very, very important thing which I had to decide very quickly, because honestly we had not planned for this session. And like honestly, we have planned that we are going to do sessions on Friday also, but as it's a Christmas, we were in 2 minds whether to do it or not. And finally you guys helped us out to decide that yes, we should do a session. So for the giveaway, what you need to do is you need to comment on any 10 of our YouTube videos and share this session in public mode on different Facebook groups. And yes, 5 lucky winners are going to get goodies from us, and we would be more than happy to share our stuff with you all. Hi Mani, so let's start with the session. Now this is an old sweet box which was lying at my place, so I have decided to do some mixed media art. Now I know I need to prep up the base, so for prepping up the base here I am using a gesso. All the supplies used in this session will be mentioned in the comment section, you can check that. And once we are done with this session, we are definitely going to share all the links with you all. Also, we are sharing the WhatsApp link where you can join, and yes, you will get a huge discount coupon if you join our WhatsApp group. Those coupons are going to be shared only on our WhatsApp group and Facebook page only. Okay, now here I have already prepped up the base of this lid. I'm not going to work on the base now, the box base. So yes, this is one of the beautiful napkin which I bought recently, and I thought of using this. Okay, now this is as it is, like, extremely beautiful, so I really don't have to work on it. But if I have some of the amazing supplies, then why not? Okay, now for taking out my decoupage napkin design, let me just see how much area it covers. Okay, yeah, I think this is going to just fit perfectly, so I really don't have to do a lot of trimming work here. So instead of water brush technique, let me just cut this down so my work becomes much more easier. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I will cut this along the lines, like along the design, not the lines, along the design. And yes, ta-da, my napkin design is ready. You need to share this in the public mode so that we know that you have shared it. If you are sharing it in a private mode, we will not be able to see the live sessions. And yes, the winner's goodies are going to be sent only on any of your Indian postal address. So yes, just keep that in mind. Okay, now here we are done. This looks gorgeous. Now what I am going to do is I am going to remove the plies off this. Okay, removing the plies is very important, so please do keep that in mind. Do participate in our giveaway, because we are having 5 lucky winners for this session. Yes, particularly for this session, you need to comment on 10 of our YouTube videos and share the session as much as you can. Now first I'm going to use my Mod Podge. That's a very basic thing what you need to do your decoupage technique. Now let me just see. So this is actually going to cover my complete box. Okay, so I will apply Mod Podge on my complete box. Now in this tutorial you are going to learn an amazing technique that when you are sticking your decoupage napkin in smaller pieces, it's much more easier. But if you have a bigger size napkin, like if you are taking up a complete napkin size, that really matters a lot. Why? I will tell you. Because sticking the bigger size napkin is really difficult. Okay, so we need to keep that in mind while doing our decoupage work. Now here I'll take up a very big brush so that my work becomes much more easier, and I'll start from one of the corners. Oops, yeah, just hold your napkin. We don't have to stick the complete napkin at one go. Then slowly start sticking this on your base. Okay, so very gently with a dry brush I'm sticking this on my base. And can you see this? Even if there are some wrinkles, it's absolutely fine. I know that should not happen, but if it happens, take up any dry sponge dauber and start pressing this. Now can you see the lines are just, you can't even see that there were some lines, there were some wrinkles, there were some bubbles. No, not at all. Okay. I'm going to stick this on the sides. I just need to add some more Mod Podge on the sides also. Now, Mod Podge is really important, just in case if you have missed out on a tutorial on how to make your decoupage glue. It's there on our YouTube channel. And yes, sharing this post is really important because that really helps us in getting more viewers, and it really encourages us when we know that yes, people are liking our work. So yeah, please do share this session as much as you can. And also every Monday we are going to come on our YouTube channel. That on our YouTube channel we are going to have a live session. Now someone is asking, Ekta is asking me, how will you get to know that we have commented on 10 videos on YouTube channel? Ekta, there is a system by which I can know that how many people have commented and what they have commented on each and every video, so I can easily keep a track of that. So do not worry. Yes, please do share this session as much as you can. That's going to be a great help to us. Okay, now once this is done, very quickly I need to use my heat gun. Okay, so now my napkin is very wet. I have to make sure that it dries up well so that we can remove the remaining wrinkles out of it. But we can't press the napkin right now, so we have to be really careful. My hands are reaching to just press this and just remove all the wrinkles, but we have to be really careful when we are doing this. If you guys have any query, you can comment below. I will be answering to all the questions the moment I'm done with this session. And Deepa, you are really pro in decoupage. Ma'am, no, not at all. I'm still learning. I still do a lot of mistakes. And I'm still learning. I'm still learning mixed media also. I'm still learning decoupage also. Okay, now once my napkin has dried out partially, so here what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to press this with my fingers. You need to make sure that your napkin, your decoupage glue or the Mod Podge has dried out to almost 70-80%. Hi Nilimaji, I hope you are doing good. Okay, so here my napkin has dried out pretty well. Now it's time to do a lot of other mediums on the top of it. So, but before that, what we need to do is we need to seal this up. Now for sealing this up, I'm going to use a varnish. Now which varnish I'm using, that is mentioned in the comment section. You can check that. I will have to take up a dry and clean brush. Hi RP, thank you so much everyone for joining us. Now first I need to seal this up with a varnish. This is a water based varnish. Which varnish I'm using, you need to check that on our YouTube channel. Okay, so here we are almost done. Now this is a very quick process. This does not take much of time. It's just that I need to make sure that my drying process is done properly, and this is very important. Why is it important? It's mentioned on all my videos on my YouTube channel, so definitely you can check it there. Aarti, why I dilute the varnish? I have already mentioned a video on the description box. That's a very, it's a very technical thing why I add water to it. You will have to check that video for the complete details. It's very difficult for me to explain that in just one line. So please check that on our YouTube channel. Hi Farida, today we are going to alter a sweet box. And yes, I have also done one of the altered boxes. I have just shown that at the starting of the session. So what you can do is, you can check that on our YouTube channel. That video is already there. Okay, so very quickly I'm trying to dry this up. Now what I have to do is I need to take up my fussy cut scissor, and this is one of the beautiful designs from Transforme. I'm going to use this. Which link you are not able to open, Anubha, please let me know. Okay, so now here I'm just trying to figure out some of the beautiful butterflies, and I think these green ones are going to look Great. I'm not doing the very typical fussy cutting work here because it is not required with these sheets. And I'm trying to like, it has already some of the blue colors. So I'm trying to figure out the colors, the different shades what I can add to it. So as in one sheet you have different varieties of butterflies. So this is definitely one of my favorite transfer me sheets from Dress My Craft. From where to buy these sheets, I have already mentioned in the comment section. You can check that. Okay. So three, and I think let me do with these ones right now. And can I have one more? Let me pick up this one also. This is also looking very cute. I picked up all the small cute little butterflies because my image, whatever I have here, is not that big. Anuja, if you are unable to join our WhatsApp group, you can just connect with us. And yes, the links we are sharing there on our comment section, you can try that. Otherwise, you can connect us with on WhatsApp and I'll add you to that group. Okay, so here I'm just doing a bit of extra, whatever the extra amount of paper is there, I will cut that. Three and four, I think four. I think four tissue, four butterflies will be sufficient. If required, we can immediately cut it and use it. So just because it has such an easy process, it is not going to much of take much of time of mine. Okay, now this is the transfer me sheet what I'm using today. We are mentioning all the supplies link in the comment section. You can check that. Do not miss out on these two. Okay, now let me start placing my butterflies. Honestly, with this thing you don't have to add butterflies, but I really wanted to have some of the cute little butterflies because I know that Vanya loves it and I'm sure she's going to love this one. Now, how to use the transfer me? You just need to remove the plastic film from the top. Okay. And you need to start sticking it. So here I'm trying to stick it on the sides also because the surface area is small. So yes. And yes. I will add on few more transfer me. I know my butterflies are going above the clouds, but it's absolutely, absolutely fine. Yes, please do check our website because we are coming up with few more new supplies. And yes, on our Monday session, we are going to have some amazing discounts on our supplies. So please, please, please do join our YouTube channel. How to join that? You just need to subscribe to our channel so that you do not miss out any of our updates. Okay. Now we are done with sticking of our transfer me. Now what I need to do is I need to take a sponge dauber. I'll take up a small size sponge dauber so that working with that is easier for me. Okay. I'll dab it in water. See, this is the water what I have, and I'll start dabbing it on my transfer me sheets. If you tried out, it's not working out, try it out on another piece. Start with the small pieces and it's definitely going to work out. Okay. Likewise, I'm going to dab all my transfer me sheets. Okay. So these are the four pieces what I have sticked here. How to know that your transfer me sheet has sticked well? Because you, the moment you're done with us with the water dripping, it will, like, you can see the design almost 50%. Okay, there should not be less water, there should not be too much of water. And I think, oh wow, see, this has already come out. Can you see this? Yeah, this looks gorgeous. Oh, this one has also come out. Now with the third one and fourth one. So I think this looks great. Is it visible now? I hope the design is visible. Can you see this? This looks absolutely gorgeous and beautiful. Now, very quickly, I need to run my heat gun. Why? Because, oops, we just need to make sure that it dries up well. I can't use my heat gun directly, so I'm going to run it on the sides and the back side of the cap. And once I'm happy with the drying process, then we are going to move on to the next step. I know many of you have asked me for the stencil work, and yes, today we are going to do that. Now, any queries, please do let me know in the comment section, and do not forget to check our YouTube channel too. Let me pick up some of the stencils. So yeah, how do I keep my stencils? So this is one of the folders. This is one folder. I also have few of the very big packs of stencils. Just in case if you want to see my stencil collection, then please do let me know in the comment section. I will be more than happy to show you all. So this is one of my recent favorites. I really don't remember the brand. I'm extremely sorry. I will try to post the link of this stencil as soon as I can. Okay, no, let me pick up another one. I am thinking of what kind. Should I go for floral patterns or some geometric patterns? Okay. Let me go with this one. Okay, now this is one of the very nice brick pattern stencil. But as it's a kid theme box, so we'll go for some nice bright colors on this. And blue. Okay, let me add this green and blue. Let me see how we are going to blend in the colors. Now, for blending the colors on stencil, you will need this stencil brushes. It's there on our website. You can check that. And yeah, okay. Now, what I'm going to do is I will take up just a tinge of color. Okay. On my brush, and I'm going to just swirl it. Can you see? I have very, very less color. Just let me know if this is good with lights or without lights. Just let me know, guys. Very soon I'll be doing a video on stencils, so yes, please do stay tuned. Now, with the stencil brush, I'm going to just run it like this. Okay, like I said, I'm going to play around with the colors. So right now I'm doing it in this pattern. Can you see this? There is no compulsion that it has to be in a straight line. Definitely no. You don't have to be that particular. And I'm going to run this on my front base. Okay, now why I'm running it on the front base? Just to make sure that my design is running on the background. Can you see this? This looks like one design has been running here. So this is a very important step. Now, let me do it on this side and show you. Let me pick up one more color, because we definitely don't want this to be a typical boyish thing. Let us add some more shades to it, and I do not mind adding up shades. Okay, now here on the sides, I'm going to run this my another shade, and you can see that I am running this on my transforme sheets, I'm running this on my decoupage napkin, and it's working out perfectly. Like, there is no problem with the transforme sheet. So yes, many of you have been asking me on my YouTube channel, can we layer up this transforme? Definitely you can do it. Do not worry. Try it out and you are going to love it. The links are mentioned in the comment section. And this looks gorgeous. So I'm just trying to blend two colors. Honestly, I should have taken up two stencil brushes. But now I will have to open a new pack. So I'm just thinking of doing this one only. And this is actually looking gorgeous. Can you see the color combination? Oh, this looks so pretty. Now I'm going to run this on my bottom part of the box. Now on the bottom part, I'm going to have a little more of blue color. Just to blend this. Okay, and in the center, I will have this nice pink color. Now, of course, when my two colors are blending, it's going to look a little different, which is what I am really liking. And can you see this color combination? This looks gorgeous. Let me do a bit more of stamping here, or stencil work here. Okay, and this looks fab. Isn't it fab? Now I'm going to repeat the process on the other patterns. We have mentioned all the supplies link in the comment section. You can check that. And this looks super, super gorgeous. Isn't it beautiful? Yes. Please do participate in our giveaway. Why? Because we are going to pick up 5 lucky winners. What you need to do is you need to share this session as much as you can. And 5 lucky winners are going to get a goodie bag from us. And this is how my box looks now. I still have to do a lot of stencil work here, which we will be doing. Do not worry. We are going to cover it as much as we can. Okay. And yes, isn't it looking great? Isn't it looking beautiful? I'm loving this one. Now let me add a few more stencil work here and there. We still have one process to left. It's not that we once we are done with the stencil, it's done. No, 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 not at all. We have to do a lot of work now. See, we still have to do a lot of work. So honestly, if you can imagine, this was actually a rainy theme stencil. Okay, now what I have to do is I have actually converted it into a beautiful and colorful gift box. So this was actually an old sweet box where you get from any of the local sweet box store, and now we have converted it into a gift box which I can use for like any of the favor boxes or anything. Okay, and on the edges I'm just going to use my brusher to blend in the edges. Okay, now this part is almost done. So you can see that I have done my stencil work on my Transforme, on my decoupage napkins and papers, and yes, it's looking fab. Now we need to quickly dry this because we are going to do a lot of gold gliding work on the top of it. How we are going to do it, that you will see us doing now. Transforme sheets are mentioned in the comment section. You can check that. Also do participate in our giveaway and we will be more than happy to share some of the goodies from our craft room with you all. Okay, now very quickly I'm going to use my heat gun to dry this up. Yes, of course, we need to dry this chalk paint before moving to the next step. And very quickly, I'm going to use my varnish to seal this up. Okay, now I'm going to repeat this process on the sides. This is very, very, very important. Sealing up your project is very important. Anyways, at times I feel that I'm addicted to varnish. Why? Because it really gives a lot of strength to your projects. And that's very important. Because if you are putting up so much of effort, if you are putting up so much of supplies, and you are putting up so much of time, it should definitely, definitely last. Okay, now once I'm done with this, again, quickly, I'm going to use my heat gun. Hi, Kalpana. Thank you so much, Mala. And thank you Bhanupriya, thank you Anita. And yes, all the supplies links are mentioned in the description box. You can check that. You can also leave your comments on our YouTube channel. We will be more than happy to have you all there on our YouTube channel. And on Monday, if you want to join us for our live session, you need to connect with us on YouTube. Yes, just in case if you have missed out us on our YouTube channel, you need to check, connect with us on our YouTube channel. Okay, now once I am happy with this, a little more of drying process, because before the gold gliding we have to make sure that it dries up well, otherwise we will not be able to move on to the next step. And okay, now this is the gold gliding leaf which I use, and this is the adhesive which I use. The links are mentioned in the comment section, you can check that. And yes, our team members are sharing all the links. Now for this one, I prefer to have a nice clean a flat brush so that my work becomes much more easier. Now my surface has dried out completely. So what I'm going to do is, I'll just take up some adhesive. This is how it looks like. Okay. And I'm going to apply this on the parts wherever I want the gold foiling effect. Okay. So I'm just going to dab it on my umbrella. Okay, just a brush of work on my umbrellas. Then I'm going to have it on the edges of my box. Okay. So usually it takes 15 to 20, like anything between 15 to 20 minutes or 10 minutes to get charged up. Yes, it takes time to have the adhesive start reacting. Yes, it definitely takes time. Okay, so I'm going to run this on the edges also. Now we are going to do it on the other sides also. So what happens is, if you're working on a bigger surface, the remaining area becomes much more like it starts reacting, that adhesive starts reacting, so it gives you ample amount of time to start working on it. Now let me put a container on the beneath so that I can keep my box on the top of it. Okay. Now how to know that your image has started working out, your adhesive started working out? You need to just touch it and see if it is sticky. Yes, if it's sticky, it has started working out. We'll just leave it for 2 minutes. Until then, I can read your comments. Farida, what is this? This is gold gliding. Unknown Nitika, we cannot use any other adhesive. This is the adhesive. The link is mentioned in the comment section. You need to check that. Foiling sheets, I've been using this for a quite long time. So yeah, I'll completely shout out for this particular product. You can check that. I got this from Amazon. I'm sharing the link in the comment section. You can check that. Okay. Now everything is just falling apart from my table. I really don't know why. Yeah. Okay. Now we are going to start with our gold foiling. So usually it comes in either in a box where you have small particles, or you have these kind of sheets. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to pick up a good flat brush. Okay. Now these are the Anukul brushes what I'm going to use. Now see how many sheets I've already used, and I've been using this for almost like 1 year now. And this is my second box. And I will start sticking it. Now I know I had done it on my umbrella. So I'll just pick up very, very small parts from this sheet pack. Okay, I already have some pieces here, so I'm going to use this. Then we'll move on to the another sheet. Just take up small portions of it. Do not touch it with your fingers, because they stick to your hands very quickly, and that's a waste. So I'm just going to dab it on the box wherever we are going to use it. Okay, now can you see this, the look of this? Let me switch on the light. I think, yeah, can you see the gold foiling work now? I think this is more visible now. Let me, yeah, I'll just open this. So I'll start sticking my gold foiling sheets, and you can see that how beautifully it is sticking on my base, and this is turning out to be so beautiful. Just rub the sheets and wherever you have put on the adhesive, and it's done. Okay, you should not touch the leaves with your hands, because it's just going to get wasted. Take up a good quality brush, like I've been using my Anukul brushes only with these ones, and they work beautifully.
Okay, and can you see this? Yeah, can you see this gold foiling part? This looks gorgeous. This looks absolutely beautiful. So gold foiling is not a new technique, but yes, many of us don't know in India that it's a beautiful form of art, which really helps in transforming your project from a simple project to a beautiful project with just two supplies. For this, you cannot use any other adhesive. You need to use this particular adhesive, and there is another one more link adhesive which I have tried and it worked good for me, and we are mentioning all the links in the comment section. You can check that. Now, wherever you have put on the adhesive, you just need to take up a small portion of your gold foiling sheet and stick it. So whichever the extra part is, it's going to just come down. Yes, this process takes a bit of time, but once this is done, this looks gorgeous. Now, so I'm going to stick it wherever I can and wherever I have put up my adhesive so that it sticks well. Isn't it amazing? You just have to take up a simple any of the old boxes and you can convert it into a beautiful gift boxes. Now, these are the boxes which can be used for such a longer time. Like just now I had shown you a box in the unicorn theme. That video tutorial is also there on our YouTube channel. You can check that. And giving a makeover to old boxes is something which I absolutely love. Let me take this out and yes, can you see this? Now very quickly I'll start with adding a lot of gold foiling sheets. Do not touch these with your hands, otherwise it just gets wasted, which we definitely don't want. Okay, now this looks gorgeous. Can you see this corner? This looks beautiful, and I'm going to repeat this process on all the parts wherever I have used my adhesive. Now if you want, you can have second coat of adhesive also on the areas wherever you have just forgotten to put it up. It's absolutely fine. The more matte your base is, the better it becomes for you to work on the parts. Like if you check the tutorial which is there on our YouTube channel, you will be able to make out the difference, like what kind of bases you should go for. And yes, it really helps. Now I'm just tapping my finger to know wherever I had put up my adhesive, those portions becomes sticky. Okay, so it becomes much more easier. Okay, so we are almost done. I'm just going to rub it on the surfaces and see if I had added my adhesive there, because I'm unable to find it. And yes, these are the portions where we had used our adhesive, the gold gliding adhesive, and this looks gorgeous. And I think this is looking absolutely fab. Isn't it amazing? And I hope you all are loving this one, and I absolutely love creating this one. Thanks to you all guys who said yes for the today's live session, otherwise we would have not created such a beautiful gift box today. And yes, here we are done. So this looks super gorgeous. This looks super beautiful. The links of all these supplies is mentioned in the comment section. You can check that. And now we are open for your questions, just in case if you guys have any queries. Now, do you want to see the complete project? Let me show you. So this is how my box looks like, a beautiful golden and decoupage with transforme work, and this looks amazing. Yeah, this is looking absolutely beautiful. Just let me know in the comment section if you like this video, and do let me know if you want us to come up with some more sessions like this on Monday. Do not forget to join us on our YouTube channel for another crafty session. Now, any queries, and I will be more than happy to. Sweetie, you couldn't find the unicorn video. I will be sharing that link the moment I am done with this session. Any other queries? Any other queries? It's looking beautiful. Thank you so much, Mani. Thank you so much, Komal. Thank you so much, Vanita. Pooja, you need to check the link to know about the price of this these supplies. And yes, we are going to varnish this now. I was just waiting for it for a couple of minutes to dry out. Yes, and the moment we are done with it, we have to seal this up because that is very important. Now, before doing my varnish work, yeah, I'm just going to take up my box and start rotating it from the sides. And the moment you add your varnish to your gold foiling, it becomes completely matte, and that is something which I really love. Which varnish I'm using, you need to check our video on that. The video link is mentioned in the comment section, and I hope you all will like that. Yeah, so this is how my box looks like after my varnish work, and this is looking gorgeous. This is absolutely looking gorgeous, and I hope this is visible to you guys now. So ideally I'm going to have a good 2 coats of varnish on this. On Monday, sharp at 3 o'clock on our YouTube channel, of course we are going to have a giveaway on that also. And yes, for today's session, we are going to pick up 5 lucky winners. What you need to do is comment on any 10 of our YouTube videos. And then the next thing is to share the session as much as you can. And do let me know what else you want us to come up with, what else you want us to create with. Sharp 3 o'clock on our YouTube channel. How to find our YouTube channel? You just need to search for Growing Craft and you can find us for sure. Any other queries? How do we have to? Yes, we have to varnish it. What time on Monday? 3 p.m. sharp. Yes, Deepika, there are tons of video which is there on our YouTube channel. You just need to search for Growing Craft. And if you scroll down our videos in the last 3-4 months, we have done a lot of transforme videos. Those are going to be really, really helpful. Nivisha, for any other craft query, please comment on our YouTube channel because it's very difficult to reply back here for the queries regarding the varnishes and other products, and I'll definitely do that. Yes. What products you want us to work on? Where can I get this tissue? Is there available on our website growingcraft.com? Nivisha, calendar. What calendar? You want me to make a calendar or what? I couldn't get it. If you can just explain that. Did I miss out any of your queries regarding this session? Thank you so much, Latika. Please do leave your feedback on our YouTube channel. I will be more than happy. Also, please do follow our page. You just need to click on the follow button. And also, please do give the review on our page. We absolutely love reading your reviews. Please show us on steel. Aarti, that video is already there on our YouTube channel. You can check that. Glass or tiffin, I have already done that, Aarti, on our YouTube channel. All these, like, we have more than 650 videos on our YouTube channel, and all those are absolutely free. You can check that. We have done it on plastic, we have done it on terracotta, we have done it on clay products, we have done it on steel, we have done it on cardboard, we have done it on MDF, we have done it on wood, we have done it on plywood. So on canvas sheets, canvas bags, cloth, and almost on all the bases we have done. Aarti, the link, you just need to scroll on to our YouTube channel, you'll find all the videos. Okay, Nimisha, I'll definitely try. Sweetie, I'll share the link the moment I'm done with the session. Till then, please do participate in our giveaway. How to participate? You need to share this session as much as you can. And you need to comment on 10 of our YouTube videos. Asma, you can find us on Instagram, on Facebook page, on Facebook. We also have a Facebook group where you can share your artwork, and every month we select one lucky winner. And yes, and on YouTube, you just need to search for Growing Craft. Everywhere, we are just with the same name, Growing Craft. Jyoti, if you can just reply back with the link name to Aarti, that will be easier for her to find us. Yes, so we have just posted the link of our YouTube channel. You can check that. And any more queries. So I think we are done with today's session. Do join us on Monday sharp at 3 o'clock on our YouTube channel. Because we are going to have only one giveaway, but that's going to be a huge, huge, huge giveaway on this Monday. Why? Because we are going to step into 2021, and that's a big thing. That's a definitely calls out for a celebration. So yes, do join us on Monday, sharp at 3 o'clock on our YouTube channel. And thank you so much for dropping in. And this is the box which we have created. I'm just going to let this dry. Then I'm going to have good 2-3 coats of varnishes on the top of it, and we will be done. Yes, thank you so much for joining in. Latika, there are a lot of gliding foil. Yes, Latika, we have already mentioned the link in the comment section. You can check that. Those are the ones which we really like. So there are 2-3 brands which I have already tried out, and they are working beautifully for us. Any other queries? Okay, so I think we are done for today. Thank you so much everyone for joining us. And please do join us on Monday sharp at 3 o'clock on our YouTube channel. On Mondays, we will be doing our live session on YouTube channels only. So please do join us, because we are going to have one bumper giveaway on that particular day. Okay, so yes, thank you so much for joining in, and yes, take care. Bye-bye.